an honor to be able to help out. I understand that. I'm not blaming you directly. Dr. Salvato, how long have you been here?
About a year now, Doctor.
And in that year, how many times have we had this conversation about late or missing shipments of supplies?
I believe this is the third time.
Yes, that sounds right. Three times. I will be making it very clear to your superiors that lives are at stake, and the clinic requires reliable transport. If your company cannot meet our needs, someone else will.
Yes, ma'am. Understood.
Thank you, Dr. Salvato. You may return to your duties.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Not exactly a hotbed of criminal activity here, is it?
Well,
that suits me fine. Yeah? Got some trouble? Oh, now hold on a minute. You're the new deputy, ain't you? Yeah, the Marshal's been sending out reports, keeping us all in the loop in your investigation.
Yep, I'm pretty well caught up on things.
Ben Armistead, pleased to meet you.
Well,
I guess that's the long and short of it. You're the newest member of the Rangers, and I'm the oldest. So, is one of them first mercenaries here at the clinic? Well, every Ranger knows it's important to trust your instincts. No better place in the settled systems to get medical treatment. You can bet it beats anything them UC piglets got. Ironic. Given they're the ones who built it. I know just the man who can help you. Right this way, Deputy. Just between you and me, I ain't entirely sure why someone felt the need to station a Ranger out here. I'm not much more than a glorified bodyguard for Dr. Darvish. She's the one in charge around here. And she's also on the Council of Governors. Most of the staff don't seem fond of the idea of me being here, and I ain't fond of them right back. Bunch of stuffy eggheads, if you ask me. Except Ari, that is. He's about the only one I can have a conversation with. Now, hey there, Ari. Working hard or hardly working?
Hey, Chief. A little more the former than the latter. What brings you by?
Well, the deputy here could use some help. Came looking for someone who might be a patient.
I'll see what I can do.
Well, I'll leave you in Mr. Miller's capable hands. You need anything else, I'll be in my office.
It's quiet back here. Guess I shouldn't complain.
I'll try to help you, but our computer systems have been having some issues. The patient records database is acting up. Access is a lot slower than normal, and I have no idea why. I'll look into it later. For now, let's focus on your investigation. Huh. Well, we don't give the patients free access to our computer system, so I doubt that's related. And still, it's worth keeping in mind. So who's the suspect you're after? Former soldier, huh? Yeah, they say war changes people forever. Makes me sad, the thought of soldiers who come home and don't fit in anymore. The name's not ringing any bells, but maybe we can approach this another way. Do you know what was wrong with her? That should help narrow things down. I can access the patient records from my terminal, assuming the database cooperates. Come on.
It'd be enough to know that the Rangers are keeping an eye on us, but to have it be my own husband, so comforting.
Okay, give me just a minute here. Maya Cruz, come on, Maya. I need you to be in here. Okay, finally, here we go. Oh. No matches found for Maya Cruz. If Maya's here, then she's got to be using an alias. Which actually makes a lot of sense if she's a wanted woman. Yeah. Let me think for a second. All right, hang on. I know that we do have a few female patients staying with us. There's Candace... what's her last name? Doolin. Candace Doolin. And then there's the Nakamori woman. I think her name's Jane. I don't recall offhand what they're here for, but it's a start. You're welcome to use the Ranger Station terminal. I'll enable admin access for you.
Evening, sir.
If you're thinking about going into medicine, just be really sure before you commit to it.
I don't mean to be rude, but unless this is a medical emergency, we need someone else to help.
Satisfied to see that you survived your most recent sleep cycle.
Was a pleasant change of scenery.
Captain, greetings.
Heard your ship, Doc. If you are who I think you are, then you're here to bring me in. I had to warn you.
Ah. He wants down Ekron set up shop here. That crystalline formation looks quite intriguing.
Yeah.
robots to do the majority of our heavy lifting. Damn cold here. Going to need a hot cup of coffee after this. Find anything useful on there? I've never seen a single crystalline formation of that size.
What are you waiting for? Finish it. Of course I ain't. What kind of fool would be eager to die? I'm just not stupid enough to deny what's inevitable. I wish I were. How about I make this real simple for us both? I've got maybe a few weeks to live, and I ain't spending them behind bars. You want to put an end to me here and now? Then fine. Get it over with. Life's kicked me around enough as it is. But if you want to let me die on my own terms, then leave me in peace. Well, how about a test? Rangers are known to be handy with a gun. But here's a problem you'll have to solve with your brain instead. I've encrypted this slate. If you can crack it, you'll learn something useful. Now get out of here and leave me in peace.
This is quite a find.
I'm sure they're sad to see you go.
I picked up something you might be interested in. So long.
Take a look around. Feel free to look around. I'll say right up front, here.
Deputy.
A lot of famous people visiting.
I feel for the folk in the stretch. I try and give a credit or two to the low house.
New deputy, huh? Honor to have you.
I specialize in cryptography. A lot of smugglers use coded slates, so comes in handy. Hey there, Deputy. How goes the hunt for the first? Good, good. If you ask me, I don't think they stand a chance. You're like an Ashta creeping silently through the high grass, waiting for your chance to pounce, and then boom! Down they'll go. So, did you get any more of those encrypted slates? Because, let me tell you, I am so close. Who, me? Doubt you? Not a chance, Deputy. I knew you were a natural the moment I laid eyes on you.